Good evening, and welcome to the Kenneth J. Minard Center for the Arts. As a courtesy to both the audience and the artists, please silence all electronic devices and note that flash photography and video recording are strictly prohibited. Sound Puget Sound Community College is located on the ancestral lands of the Stachas Band of the Squaxin Island Tribe and the Squally Indian Tribe, who have long been stewards of the region's waters, plants, and animals. The southernmost point of the Salish Sea, these lands were, and still are, a place of gathering, trade, and community for many Coast Salish peoples. We recognize that all who are not Salish peoples are visitors here. We commit to join these peoples to share their history, build relationships, increase representation, and restore the living world around us. To comply with our state's roadmap to recovery, please keep your face masks on throughout the event, covering your nose and mouth. For your safety and the safety of those around you, please take a moment to identify the nearest emergency exit, keeping in mind that it may be behind you. You may see some empty seats around you. If you feel more comfortable shifting a few seats over to make more distance between you and another guest, we invite you to do so now. This performance will include a 20-minute intermission. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Well, hi, good evening, everybody. It's nice to be here. We're very happy to be here. We're very happy you're here. So thank you for coming and supporting us in our return to live music making. Thanks, Mom. So this is a little bit of a quarter in transition. Obviously, we were virtual all through last year, folks hung in there, did very difficult things, recorded tracks, and we did a bunch of stuff that I do not care to ever repeat. But anyway, we kept going, and this is sort of our halfway point. We brought back strings in person this fall, and we'll be transitioning back to full orchestra in winter quarter. So we're very excited for that, but we have also very enjoyed getting to explore this area of the repertoire with just string players. And in choosing music for this program, I really wanted to showcase a variety of styles that string instruments are capable of playing in. So for example, that first piece, the composer who was the great legendary African-American composer William Grant Still was imitating traditional instruments from Panama. So you heard some tapping, you heard some catchy rhythms, and various other things. So that's kind of one lane. And we're going to go into a very different lane now. And we're going to play a piece by a friend of mine named Carolyn Quick. You can read. You can read more about her in the program notes that the fabulous Ann Edge wrote for us, as usual. I did this piece once before, a few years ago, gave the world premiere performance in Illinois in 2017. And I think this is the, what did we say, West Coast or Pacific Northwest premiere, one of those, depending on who you ask. This is either the first time this piece is being performed on the West Coast or in the Pacific Northwest. One of those. Anyway, you can read more of the story in your program, but when this was coming together here, you may have noticed we're sitting a little further apart than usual, and I only have four people in the front row instead of the normal eight for a string section. And this piece features a quintet of soloists. So the principal players of each section, these four people plus Mr. Nick Masters on bass, have significant solos in this, almost like a solo quartet plus bass. And so this is really a wonderful piece for this type of setup. If you're familiar with the string orchestra repertoire, it's sort of a combination of Barber Adagio and Vaughan Williams' Talis Fantasia. You might hear little bits of each, not direct quotes, but stylistic similarities. And the Vaughan Williams in particular has a solo quartet in the front, so this emulates that a little bit. But they, I think I can speak for them in that they've really enjoyed working on this. And as I said, it's quite a different style from the piece you just heard. So this is Waves Like Glass by Carolyn Quick.
Thank you.
That, of course, was yet another aspect of string playing. We've got one more, saving the biggest piece for last. And no concert, in my opinion, of string orchestra music would be complete without at least one work by an English composer, because nobody did string music better than the English did. And there are a lot of pieces I could have chosen. This one doesn't get done as often. And Hubert Parry, or Sir Charles Hubert Hastings Parry, if you want to be technically pedantic, is not as well known in the orchestra world, better known in the choral world. And this is just a delightful piece. That was John over there. So you may have heard of some more familiar names, such as Edward Elgar, Ralph von Williams, Gustav Holst. These folks were either friends or students of Hubert Parry. So you might say that none of their famous works, such as the Elgar String Serenade, von Williams' Palace Fantasia, or many other string works, Greensleeves, or Holst's St. Paul Suite, or any of those other great string pieces that get done a lot. Really, Hubert Parry is kind of one step backwards in the lineage. So this piece has seven movements. We're going to do six of them tonight. And once again, there is a fabulous opportunity for a little bit of solo work in this setup. So the six movements together are about 20 minutes. And then after that, we will take an intermission and reset the stage for the jazz band. So this is An English Suite by Hubert Parry.
Thank you.
Okay, well, welcome back. New faces, same great place. So we're going to play seven tunes for you tonight. So the first one is an arrangement of In a Mellow Tone from the Duke Ellington Library. And this is going to feature Levi on the trombone, and it's going to... Levi fans in the house. And it's also going to feature Michael on alto sax. Hi, Marie. Is our ballad, and this is kind of a pop ballad style, and it's going to feature the person on stage who has been involved with this group the longest, which is Mary Griffin on alto. So this is Song for Haley.
Thank you.
next up is an arrangement of All Blues by Miles Davis. And this is going to feature Greg Allison on trumpet. And hi, Karina. And also Francisco Castillo on bass. Okay, chugging right along. Next up is a Nestico tune. This is All right, okay, you win, and this will feature Renzo on the trumpet. At this point, I just assume that everybody has fans, so feel free to applaud. So Renzo on trumpet, and then Knapp on the Barry sax. And I just have to add that this is our first time with the brand new Barry sax that the college bought this past year. So if the light is shining in your eyes, I apologize. It's probably reflecting off the shininess of the new instrument. Here we go. This is All Right, Okay, You Win. Could go at the end, but wait, there's more. One of the things that happened this quarter when I found out I was going to be doing this, and when I found out we were going to be having just strings in the orchestra this fall. I gave my woodwind, brass, and percussion players that normally play in the orchestra two options. Number one, they could play in the wind ensemble at St. Martin's University, which has been set up to offer SPSCC credit for playing over there with their music professor, Dr. Dave Wasik. And some folks did that. Also, the other option was I said, hey, why don't you come play in the jazz band? So we had a couple of folks do that. One of them is Linda Girard, who Linda plays clarinet in our orchestra, and she's playing tenor sax this quarter in the jazz band. And as I was looking through the library for tunes to pick, I found this lovely Ellington arrangement of I Let a Song Go Out of My Heart, and it has a clarinet feature. So we're going to feature Linda on clarinet, and also a little dialogue between Linda and Mary. Well, first Linda's going to play tenor, and dialogue with Mary between alto and tenor, and then Linda's going to switch to clarinet and do some clarinet solo as well. So this is I Let a Song Go Out of My Heart. By the way, sorry, one more thing, almost forgot. I'm very grateful to all of these people for being here, but it took a little while to get our final personnel list settled. I actually had a special sort of reduced version of this created by a friend of the SPSCC Jazz Band, also friend of SOCO, local composer and arranger Mark Thome. So this arrangement was transcribed from the for the Jazz at Lincoln Center series, and then Mark took that and consolidated it. So this is Mark's adaptation of the David Berger transcription of I Let a Song Go Out of My Heart.
Thank you.
So this is not officially a holiday concert, but I told them we would do one and start it after Halloween. So that's what we did. This is an arrangement of several of your favorite tunes from A Charlie Brown Christmas. And at this point, since you will, of course, hear the famous riffs, we did have a student pianist this year who had a family emergency at the last minute, but so we're very grateful that our piano professor, Dr. Lorna Etter, is stepping in. She had two rehearsals to figure out how all this went, and also she had a concert last night and has been in a rehearsal almost every night this week, so I'm very grateful for her stepping in and playing piano with us. So this is Charlie Brown Christmas.
Thank you.
took you to all of your favorite places in your mind. And if that wasn't enough holiday music for you, let me tell you about three other events that are coming up soon, all of which are quite different from one another. So next Saturday, a week from today, Student Orchestras of Greater Olympia is putting on the annual Sogo Ho Ho Brass Choir Holiday Show, A Clear View of the Holidays. Did I get that right? That is Mr. Allison's show that he leads. That will be next Saturday, 2 o'clock at Westminster Presbyterian Church on the east side. Then another week plus a few days will be the annual Messiah Sing-Along down at the Washington Center. That will be Tuesday, December 21st. So bring your scores and bring your masks and get ready to sing through them and love it. And then finally, 2 days after that, the Olympia Symphony Orchestra will be giving their holiday concert also at the Washington Center, quite different from any of the other two events. So plenty more holiday music in the vicinity for you to enjoy in the coming weeks. So our last selection for the evening was an instant hit when we read it through, and the first one that we settled on while we were compiling what we were going to play. So we're going to finish with a little jazz rock. This is an arrangement of Watermelon Man by Herbie Hancock, and it is going to feature Linda on tenor, Mary on alto, and Levi on trombone. Thank you very much for coming and staying and supporting live music again. We wish you all the best.